Good afternoon to everybody, dear friends. I am going to teach you about the regulation of ketogenesis. So, what are the crucial steps that regulates the ketogenesis? You know that triacylglycerol mainly stored in the adipose tissue. The first crucial step is that lipolysis. The lipolysis which occurs during the fasting state, so that more lipolysis leads to the triacylglycerol to be released to the free fatty acids. So these are the free fatty acids. When the circulating the free fatty acids are increased, and it will be subjected to the beta oxidation. And you see that these circulating the free fatty acids are mostly derived from the adipose tissue. These are mainly the first crucial step which regulates the ketogenesis. This is a step one. So when the circulating free fatty acids are very high in the blood levels, so what will happen is that when there is a high level of the circulating the free fatty acids, it crosses the hepatocytes. So these free fatty acids, they are activated into the free fatty acids are activated into SI-CoA. The SI-CoA in the fat state, when you are taking the food, it is esterified to triacylglycerol plus phospholipids. So this is again when in the fat state, it is going to be carried to the by VLDL to the blood circulation, so that the triacylglycerols can be carried over to the blood circulation. So when there is a fasting state, so what will happen? This acyl-CoA, which is there, it is mainly you know that in mitochondrial the membrane there will be a carnitine palmitoyl transferase 1, because this acyl-CoA which cannot be transferred inside the mitochondrial membrane, so this CPT1 which attaches this acyl-CoA and it makes them to enter into the mitochondrial matrix. So the acyl-CoA which is there, it is subjected to the beta oxidation. So beta oxidation takes place and it leads to the acetyl-CoA. The acetyl-CoA which is there, it is subject to the ketogenesis. So ketone bodies are synthesized. So in fasting state, what will happen? These CPT levels are increased. The increased levels of CPT is noticed in the fasting state. So when there is an increased CPT levels are there, it is more acyl-CoA is formed and more acyl-CoA is still going and the ketogenesis leads to the formulation. So in the fat state, what will happen? The CPT levels are very low level. Fat state, it will be in very low, so that the ketone bodies are very less synthesized. And again, that acetyl-CoA which is there, it has to be entered into that what you say that into the citric acid cycle. So observe acetate, the acetyl-CoA combines together to form a citrate by enzyme which is called as citrate synthesis. The citrate which is there, it is to be converted into succinyl-CoA, succinyl-CoA to fumarate, fumarate to malate, malate to the again oxalic state. So what is that enzyme which is called as malate dehydrogenase?
is converted, and here NADH plus ions, so that NAD is reduced. This is, it can be converted, malate can be converted to oxalate state, or oxalate state can be converted into malate. So this reaction, this the ratio should also be maintained properly. Here what will happen in the fed state, there will be a citrate synthetase adequately presented, so that it converts into citrate, and this cycle prompts for the synthesis of ATP molecules. So what will happen, the citrate, which again it enters into the mitochondrial membrane by the protein, which is called the transport protein, the citrate enters into the cytosol. The citrate, it is by enzyme called as ATP citrate lyase. It is converted into oxaloacetate plus, what is that called as, acetyl-CoA. And please remember that acetyl-CoA, which is formed, it is also formed from the glucose. You know that pyruvate will be formed from glucose glycolysis. During the fed state, what will happen? There is a plenty available of glucose, so the glucose will be converted into pyruvate, and pyruvate enters into the mitochondrial matrix, and from pyruvate to pyruvate dehydrogenase, it is converted into acetyl-CoA. This is one step. And another step, pyruvate to oxaloacetate is conversion by enzyme called as pyruvate carboxylase. So this happens in the fed state. So the plenty of the TCA cycle, and when the glucose is available, pyruvate enters into the mitochondria, it will be converted into acetyl-CoA. So what will happen here, whatever the acetyl-CoA that prompts with the citrate cycle, the acetyl-CoA which is formed inside the cytosol, it is acted upon by enzyme called as acetyl-CoA carboxylase. So there is a inside the mitochondrial carboxylase and acetyl-CoA carboxylase which is presented inside the cytosol. The acetyl-CoA which is converted into malonate. So malonate will be useful for the fatty acid synthesis. So this occurs in the fed state. When you are in the fed state, the citric acid cycle which is going to be formed, the citrate is going to be formed as outside the mitochondrial membrane and the cytosol, and the citrate by action of ATP citrate lyase, it is converted into acetyl-CoA, acetyl-CoA by carboxylase, it is converted to malonate, and it is useful for the fatty acid synthesis. So malonate, which is there in the fed state, it is going to inhibit the carnitine palmitate transferase 1 in the fed state. It is a potent inhibitor of that carnitine palmitate transferase 1, so that beta oxidation cannot take place, and beta oxidation is not there, acetyl-CoA is not formed, and the ketogenesis will not take place. That is another step which is malonate plays a very important role. So the second step, the crucial step, is that CPT, carnitine palmitate transferase 1 in the fed state and the fasting state. And another one is availability of oxaloacetate. You know that oxaloacetate can be formed from the glucose molecule, which is there. If oxaloacetate is very low, so the citric acid cycle doesn't prolong, and that leads to the acetyl-CoA to promote into the ketones. So this is another step which plays very important role, the step 3. So these are the mainly the three crucial steps which plays very important role in the ketogenesis. The first step is that the lipolysis, the circulating the free fatty acids, and the second one is the low levels or high levels. When that depends upon your fasting or fed state. The fasting state, more CPT levels will be there, and the CPT levels will influence us to formation of the acetyl-CoA to form the ketogenesis. And availability of the oxaloacetate, if there is no glucose is available, there is no oxaloacetate is formed, and the citric acid cycle there is no citric acid cycle, and it leads to the step way to form the ketone bodies. More ketogenesis is synthesized. So these are the main the three crucial steps. Another one is availability of NAD. The ratio will be altered. If observed state is not available, the NADH ratio will be altered so that it will lead to the malate, and malate to the again it forms. That hampers that citric acid cycle. You know that the insulin mainly insulin in the fat state, it mainly enhances the carboxylase to form the malonate. So when the malonate is there, it is used for the fatty acid synthesis, and ultimately it is going to inhibit the carnitine palmitate transferase 1 in the fat state. So when there is an insulin is not available and the glucagon is very high, so what will happen, the glucagon is going to inhibit the carboxylase. It has a positive effect upon the carboxylase, and glucagon has a negative effect upon the carboxylase. So when the malonate is not there, there is no inhibitor of carnitine palmitate transferase 1. So that ketogenesis is enhanced. The ketogenesis will be takes place more. So these are the three the crucial steps which regulates the ketogenesis process. Thank you very much.